Hello everybody, welcome to our channel, and we hope you've been waiting for us to return so we could show you another thrilling video. And here we are! We'll discuss important space updates with you today. Let's start with the update regarding the retirement of SpaceX's CTO of propulsion. Tom Mueller considers himself to be a fan of racing. In a recent interview, he stated that after leaving his position as SpaceX's CTO of propulsion in November 2020, he primarily wanted to go racing and ride dirt motorcycles and travel. Mueller, age 61, was putting an illustrious career behind him. At SpaceX, he oversaw the creation of the Merlin rocket engine, which powers the Falcon 9 rocket, and the Draco engines, which power the Dragon spacecraft. The plan was to retire, but plans don't usually go according to schedule. Mueller, widely regarded as one of the top propulsion scientists alive today, began designing a small thruster as soon as he retired. The blue supergiant in the constellation Orion inspired the name Rigel for that thruster. It's evolved into the foundation of Mueller's brand new business, Impulse Space, which he formed in September 2021. Mueller hopes that with the new business, Impulse will become the standard for affordable, effective space travel. As stated by Mueller, now it's full on. It was going to be just for fun and not too serious, but then some ex-SpaceX people started talking to me and wanted to help, and all of a sudden it became real. He also added, "Somebody asked me, how long after you incorporated Impulse did it take for investors to want to give you money?" And I said, "Well, actually, I incorporated Impulse because I had investors tell me they wanted to fund me." Perhaps understating it to say full on. With a $20 million seed round, led by Peter Thiel's Founders Fund, and a later $10 million investment from venture capital company Lux Capital, Impulse has raised an impressive sum of money for such a young space enterprise. Given Mueller's background, he didn't have to look very far, or at all, to find people eager to support his ideas financially. Additionally, Impulse hasn't had a lot of trouble hiring talent. The firm now employs about 40 employees, many of whom are members of the technical leadership team with prior experience at SpaceX, including Paul Seebacher, VP of Manufacturing, George Katigian, and Kevin Miller, VP of Propulsion. The two companies' agreement is valid until 2029. If they fail to launch in 2024, they'll have another chance when the stars, literally, next align in 2026. While Impulse will construct the Mars Cruise Vehicle spacecraft, entry capsule, and lander, Relativity will provide the launch vehicle, their heavy-lift Terran R rocket. The Mars expedition won't be Impulse's first endeavor. The company is hard at work in the interim performing tests on the Rigel engine, making and testing valves, the avionics suite, and more. The company hopes to fly an orbital transport vehicle late next year. Additionally, Mueller has demonstrated that he's not the kind to be intimidated by a challenge, despite the fact that Mars will probably be the most difficult mission on Impulse's schedule. Mueller's plan for Impulse is mostly predicated on launch becoming incredibly cheap, which would lead to a large number of payloads in space that would need to be moved around. He compared the early 1990s internet to totally reusable heavy-lift rockets like the Neutron from Rocket Lab and Terran R. A cargo of 20,000 kilograms may be carried by Terran R, while 13,000 kilos can be launched into orbit by Neutron. Each Starship launch will have the capacity to carry an incredible 100 to 150 tons if SpaceX is successful. It's difficult to even imagine the potential outcomes of such a paradigm shift in launch. Elon Musk, CEO of SpaceX, and Tim Ellis, CEO of Relativity, have each separately discussed a multi-planetary vision for the future of humanity. Mueller is undoubtedly on board to visit the Red Planet. Musk has summarized his mission in numerous public statements as one to extend the light of consciousness in the cosmos. He acknowledged that a little bit closer to home is also a source of motivation. in order to help offload Earth's resources. He referred to the moon and the possibility of a lunar and cislunar economy. The moon's surface is covered in ice and water, as well as a number of precious elements. Now it's time to take a look at our second update. A senior NASA official told Reuters on Wednesday that Moscow has told its American counterparts that until their own orbital outpost is constructed and ready for use, Moscow would like to continue sending its cosmonauts to the International Space Station, ISS. In light of recent developments and comments made by a senior Russian space official that were published on Wednesday, it appears that Russia has at least 6 more years until it ends its more than 2-decade-long orbital partnership with the United States. Tuesday, when Yuri Borisov, the recently appointed Director General of Russia's space agency, Roscosmos, stunned NASA by saying that Moscow intended to withdraw from the space station cooperation after 2024. It appeared that a rupture in the ISS program was closer at hand. Russian officials later on Tuesday informed NASA that Roscosmos wanted to continue the leadership while Russia attempts to establish its proposed orbiting outpost, known as ROS. Kathy Luders, NASA's head of space operations, said in an interview. On Wednesday, it was stated by Luders, "We're not getting any indication at any working level that anything's changed." They also added that NASA's relations with Roscosmos remain business as usual. It's been continuously inhabited for more than 20 years by a partnership led by the United States and Russia that also includes Canada, Japan, and 11 European nations. Space Station is a science laboratory the size of a football field that orbits about 250 miles or 400 kilometers above Earth. Though its future has been in doubt ever since Russia invaded Ukraine in February, straining bilateral ties on a number of fronts as the Biden administration placed economic sanctions on Moscow, it represents one of the last traces of American-Russian cooperation. Roscosmos and the European Space Agency were at odds as a result of the Ukraine crisis. Beyond 2024, there hasn't been a formal agreement reached to continue Russia's ISS participation. When the board that controls the management of the station meets on Friday, Luders said that NASA, Roscosmos, ESA, and the station's other partners intend to examine the possibility of extending each other's tenure on the laboratory beyond 2030. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.